Welcome back to Wake Up America. I'm Alex Kramer. Well, White House Press Secretary Jen Psaki was asked about President Biden's schedule and his availability for a press conference in today's
Psaki Dodge.
What is the president doing today?
Well, let's see. The president has two local interviews he will be doing later this afternoon. He has a number of internal meetings with senior members of his staff that have happened throughout the course of the day today, his presidential daily brief, and I believe there's some mayors who are visiting today as well.
What's the purpose of the meeting with the mayors?
It's not a meeting with the president, with the mayors. They're here. I'm not going to get ahead of it beyond that, but he has a full schedule today. Go ahead.
Well, thank you, Jen Psaki, for that word salad. I'd like to welcome back in our powerhouse panel, Project One National Advisory Board member Christopher Arps and former Trump campaign aide Rick Gates. Let's go to the issue that's on the minds of everybody, and it's also in the New York Post today in an article saying that President Biden has vowed to pause taxes for everyone except the rich. Remember that? He promised in his campaign, I will only tax the rich. But what is Bidenflation doing? It's taxing the elderly and wage workers. It's the cruelest tax of all. So, Christopher, your thoughts?
Yeah, I mean, we see this every day. When I go fill up my tank, I pay probably about $20 more than I did before the president became president. My wife, when she goes to the grocery store, our food bill has doubled. And you're right, Betsy, inflation is a cruel tax. And unless the president gets a hold of this, his administration, I think that's going to be one of the main reasons why they do very poorly in the midterm elections next year.
I actually have one idea. I think that those members of Congress should stop going to those fancy Capitol Hill dining rooms inside the Capitol and instead join the rest of us in our shoes as we go to the supermarket where beef prices are up 20%. I see people panicking at the meat counter. Everything in the basket is costing more. What's your thought, Rick?
Yeah, look, I've always believed, working behind the scenes with, you know, many members in administrations and that in the Congress, they have no problem spending money because it's not their money. And it's a valuable lesson in life that you understand, and every hardworking American out there understands the importance of that. And when you look at what's going on, yes, we have a historic inflation. The Congressional Budget Office just showed that the Biden Build Back Better bill is going to increase our deficit by $3 trillion. That's on top of the 2.5 that they just passed yesterday. So what you're seeing is just a chaotic pattern of spending, and it's leading to a severe economic drought that's going to hit all Americans, and it's going to cause the Democrats to lose in 2022.
Yes, let's underscore the relationship between this deficit spending, flooding the United States with all these new dollars to pay for this spending, and inflation, because that's what's happening. People who work hard and save are bearing the brunt of this because inflation is taxing them. Now on to a topic that really makes us all just plain mad. And that is former Governor Andrew Cuomo, disgraced Governor Andrew Cuomo's $5 million book deal. A state ethics commission has now ordered that money returned to the state. Actually, I shouldn't say returned to the state. It was given to him by a publisher, but now he will have to surrender that money to the state, in part because he used state employees to help write that book. And that's a real conflict with New York state law. So, Chris, what do you think of this?
Well, I think that if this investigation of Andrew Cuomo wouldn't have come out, we would have never known that he was using state resources. I think it was probably a common occurrence for him and probably other members of the government. And I just hope he didn't spend that $5 million and he can return it.
Yeah, I'm wondering when they're really going to see this money. What's your thought, Rick?
Well, I think he was governor so long that it was very easy for him to abuse the power of his office. Not just in using resources to write the book, but we know with the nursing home scandal and what he used in terms of state resources to potentially cover that up, I think that's still going to be an issue out there. And then obviously on the sexual harassment charges, obviously, which are still being investigated as well. So he's used state resources quite vastly. And I think there's still a lot more to that in narrative and what's going to come out from, you know, his actions and activities during his time as governor.
Right. Well, I'm sure we're going to get a lot more sleazy news about what happened during the Cuomo administration. Thank you to our panel. Great stuff.